Yeah, as I told you, the Lord gave us a promise for this year. Psalm 62 verse 6. He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be moved. This is the every year we will ask the Lord to give us a promise to hold on to it throughout the year. And also the Lord will give us to focus upon something. This year our focus is to stand firm on the rock. Bible says the rock was Christ. 1 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 4 says that rock was Christ. Hallelujah. Christ is the rock for our life. Amen. We need to stand firm on the rock. We need to be rooted in Jesus Christ. We need to stand firm in Jesus Christ. When we stand firm in Jesus Christ, we will not be moved. We will not be shaken. Amen. Hallelujah. On the day of January 1st, during the watch night service, I preached from that promise, Psalm 62, verse 6. Since this is the first meeting in San Jose, I am telling about the promise verse and the focus. But today I'm going to talk to you about the help of God, the Lord who helps us. Amen. Psalm 121, verse 1 and 2. These are the verses for our message for this evening. Psalm 121, verse 1 and 2. If anyone take that verse, you can read that verse. Psalm 121, verse 1 and 2. Anybody wants to read? I will lift up my eyes to the hills. From hence comes my help. My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. Amen. The psalmist says, my help comes from the Lord. Amen. Who made heaven and earth. If the Lord can create the entire heaven and earth, He can help us easily. Amen. How many of you believe that? Hallelujah. When I grew up in the school in India, you know, like in the elementary school, okay, when we were talking each other, the students talking each other, okay, if somebody's dad or uncle is a policeman, that guy will tell all with all the proud. He will say, hey, do you know my uncle is cops? My dad is a policeman. I will bring my dad and I will ask him to beat you like that. Then we all scared about that boy. Because he says, my uncle is a policeman. Right? We scared of the uncle because he has some power, right? But Bible says our God has all the power. He can create heaven and earth. Amen. We are the children of Almighty God. Hallelujah. If He can create the heaven and earth, definitely it's easy for Him to help you and me. How many of you believe that? Amen. That's why the psalmist says, my help will come from above who created the heaven and earth. Hallelujah. We all need the help of God. Amen. When I was asking the Lord, what do you want me to preach for this evening? The Lord told me that, tell my people, I am going to help them throughout this year, 2020. Amen. The Lord will hold our hands and He will help us. Amen. Hallelujah. We need the help of God. Hallelujah. If you read some more verses from this Bible and this same psalm, if you read verse 3, in what areas we need His help? First of all, we need His help to keep us away from every evil. Amen. We are living in the world which is filled with evil. Many times, many different types of evil try to attack our life. Amen. But the Lord wants to give us help to keep us away from every evil. Amen. If you read Psalm 121 verse 3, the first point is the Lord wants to keep us from the evil. For that, He is willing to send His help. Psalm 121 verse 3. He will not allow your foot to be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. Amen. Hallelujah. Many things trying to move us. Amen. But He will not allow us to move us. Amen. Many challenges trying to move our faith. Many times our faiths are shaken up. Amen. When the challenge is coming against us, when the problems rise up, many times our faith is shaken up. But the Lord wants to keep us firm. For that, He wants to send His help. Amen. Hallelujah. Many times the enemy is trying to take us away from the Lord. Many times the enemy is take away the strength from our life. Amen. The Lord wants to give us strength, but the enemy wants to take away the strength. Amen. But the Lord wants to help us. The Lord wants to keep us from every plans of the enemy. Amen. We can read Psalm 121 verse 7. Psalm 121 verse 7. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. We need to be preserved. Our soul needs to be preserved from all the evil. Hallelujah. For that, the Lord wants to help us. Amen. How many of you need that kind of help? Hallelujah. Many temptation. We live in the world filled with many temptation, many distraction, many diversion. Amen. We want to stand on the rock, but the enemy is not allowing us to stand firm on the rock. But the Lord is going to help us. Psalm 115 verse 9. Psalm 115 verse 9. Bible talks about the help of God. Psalm 115. Amen. O Israel, trust in the Lord. He is their help and shield. The another version says, He alone their help. Amen. Hallelujah. God alone can be our help. God alone can be our shield. Amen. When God is our help, when God is our shield, we can be well protected when the enemy comes against us. Amen. That's why we need the help of God. Hallelujah. He alone can our help. We can read some more verses. Psalm 22, verse 11, 12, 13. Why we need His help? What kind of world we live in? Here this psalmist, David, went through many challenges. He says few things. What kind of challenges he went through? Psalm 22, verse 11, 12, 13. David says, Lord, do not be away from me, because there is trouble and there is no one to help me. Amen. David recognized, Lord, you alone can help me. You alone my help. You alone my shield. So Lord, don't go away from me. Don't go far away from me. David realized God alone can help me. So he's longing for God's presence. Amen. When we recognize that Lord alone can help us, then automatically we will call Him. Automatically we want to be with the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. When you realize you are in trouble, when you realize there is only one person can help you, automatically you will look for that person. Right? Amen? Because you know only this person can help me. So you want to be with that person. You want that person to be with you all the time. Don't go away from me. You alone can help me. Amen? Hallelujah. Amen? Amen. That's why David said, Lord, I am in trouble. Don't go far away from me. There is no one to help me. Hallelujah. First of all, we need to recognize He alone can help me. Amen. When we realize that, we will call upon Him. We will need His presence all the time. We want Him to be with us all the time. We will be with Him all the time. Hallelujah. That's the way David had a relationship with God. Amen. We can read the verses continuously. Many bulls have surrounded me. David knew what kind of challenges surrounded him. Amen. Hallelujah. Many times we do not know what is standing around us. Right? If we are a wise people, we will know what kind of situation we are in, what kind of trouble we are in, what kind of people surrounding us. Yes? David knew what is surrounded him. He said, many bulls surrounded me.
Strong bulls of Bashan encircled me. Like a raging and roaring lion.
I am poured out like water. See, bulls, lion.
I am poured out like water. And all my bones are out of joint.
Amen. Because of this type of challenges, because of this type of people, I do not have a strength in my joints. Amen. Whenever we are going through trouble, whenever we are going through challenges, that's why I told you it will try to take away the strength from us. It will make us weak. Amen. David went through that path, but David knew one thing, He alone my help. Amen. We can read one more verse, verse 16.
For dogs have surrounded me.
The congregation of the wicked has enclosed me. Amen. The bulls of Bashan, then lions, then dogs. Hallelujah. These all represents the kind of challenges he went through. One man went through different challenges. Surrounded me means there is no way to escape. All the way they surrounded me. There is no one to help me. Amen. But David did not give up. Because David knew, He alone my help. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, the Lord alone your help. Amen. The Lord will help you this year. Amen. Hallelujah. Bible says, He will not allow our foot to be moved. Amen. Hallelujah. Because He is the rock. Because He is going to help us. Amen. Hallelujah. Challenges will be there. But we will not be moved because He is the one going to help us. He is our help. He is our shield. Amen. We can read some more verses from the Bible. Psalm 33 verse 20.
Our soul waits for the Lord. He is our help and our shield.
Amen. Hallelujah. Again David says, my soul waits for the Lord. He alone can my help and shield. Amen. Hallelujah. When we realize He is our help, what we will do, we will wait at His presence. Amen. We will not do anything out of panic. We will not do anything out of hasty. We will wait. Hallelujah. He will come and help me. I am going to wait for His hand. I'm going to wait at His feet. I'm going to wait at His presence. Amen. Hallelujah. Whenever we are going through trouble, whenever we feel that we are helpless, what we will do, many times we want to do something immediately. Amen. We don't want to wait. Hallelujah. We have to do something, so we will rush to do something. But the psalmist says, I will wait. Hallelujah. When somebody gives you promise that I will come and help you, what you will do? You will wait for that person. Amen. Hallelujah. You will tell your friends, hey, he told me that he will come and help me, so I'm waiting for him. He told me that he will come and give me right, so I'm waiting for him. Amen. Why you are waiting for that person? Because you are trusting that person that he will come. You will wait for that person, right? If you are able to wait for a human being, why don't you wait for the Almighty God who promised you that he will help you? Amen. If you believe that the Lord will help you, you will wait for him. Amen. I want to show you about a king, what he did when he faced challenges in his life. 2 Chronicles chapter 14, verse 9. 2 Chronicles chapter 14, verse 9. Are you with me? Amen. Are you listening? Okay, good. 2 Chronicles chapter 14, verse 9. Amen. Here Bible says the Ethiopian came against King Asa. How many people came? Army of a million men and 300 chariots, and he came to that place called Masha. Amen. 1 million people came against King Asa. Amen. Hallelujah. He was in trouble. He was in a challenge. Amen. He was surrounded by the evil. He was surrounded by the enemy. Amen. But he did one good thing. He went and stand before the Lord. He was waiting at the presence of God. Hallelujah. Whenever the evil comes, the Bible encourages to go to the presence of God. Bible says, he alone your help. Amen. Wait at his feet. Wait at his presence. Amen. What this king Asa did. Verse 11.
And Asa cried out to the Lord.
He was praying to God. He was waiting for God. He was praying to God. Amen. Lord.
It is nothing for you to help.
Amen. How many of you believe that? Million is nothing before God. Hallelujah. Million army can come, but it's nothing before God. Hallelujah. Million challenges can come, but it's nothing before God. Hallelujah. King Asa believed in God, and King Asa waited at his feet. Amen. Even though he was a king, he did not do anything out of panic. The king must have many experiences of battle. Amen. But he knew, I want to wait at his feet to receive his help, because I know for him nothing difficult to help. Amen. He can help for all the situation. Hallelujah. How many of you believe that? Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. How many of you believe? Okay, for example, I'm asking a question. $100 is big one or $1 million? $1 million, of course, right? Okay, I will say, this month, the Lord is going to bless you with $100. Everybody will believe, right? Yes or no? But this month, God is going to bless you with $1 million. Right? We will think how it will be. We think $100 is easy for the Lord. $1 million is difficult for God. When I say $100, you are not thinking about any situation. Right? But when I say $100 million, immediately you will think, ow. Yes or no? I'm not talking about money, for example, I'm saying. Right? Yes or no? When you start to drive in this country, whenever you sit in the car, start to drive, and to reach the destiny all the way, you will pray. Right? Lord, help me. I need to park right. I need to get the good parking lot. Right? Nobody should come closer to me. You will pray for everything. Right? But after 3 years, 4 years, when you used up, will you pray like that? Right? Because now we know how to park, how to drive. We will pray, but not like before. Right? What I'm trying to say, whenever we feel it's very difficult for me, that time only we believe God can help me. Whenever we believe it's easy for me, that time we are not having the same kind of belief. But the Lord wants to encourage us, nothing impossible by God. Amen. You may have one challenge or few more challenges, but for God, easy to help you. Amen. Hallelujah. If it is $1 or $100 or $1,000, for everything God has to help us. To get that $1 also, we need the help of God. We need to believe that without His help, I cannot get anything. Amen. We need to have such a faith. Hallelujah. This King Asa prayed like this. We can read that verse again. Whether with many or Amen. For we rest on you, and in your name we go against this multitude, O Lord. You are our God. Do not let man prevail against you. Amen. Hallelujah. See how he prayed. We want to rest on you, Lord. Amen. He confessed that for you it's easy to help. Amen. I don't want to see the million army. I want to look upon you. You alone can help me. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Whenever you rest upon the Lord for your help, He will come and help you. King Asa waited on God and rested on the Lord, and he confessed that you alone can help me. Amen. What kind of challenges you are going through now? What kind of challenges you are facing? Maybe it looks like a mountain, but for God, it's easy to help you. Amen. Just rest upon Him. Just depend on Him. Just wait at His feet. He will come through and He will help you. The Lord, one who helped you so far, He will continuously help you. Amen. How many of you believe that? Amen. Hallelujah. He will help us every day. Hallelujah. We can read that verse 12. When he prayed like this, what happened? Amen.
So the Lord struck the Ethiopians before Asa and Judah, and Ethiopians fled, and Asa and the people who were
pursued them too. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Who helped King Asa? The Lord Himself helped. How He helped? He came through the situation. He struck the million armies. Hallelujah. Amen. When you rest upon the Lord for His help, He will take care of your battle. Amen. He will come and clear all the challenges. That's why we need to rest upon Him for every help. Amen. We need to say, You alone my help. You alone my shield. Hallelujah. I want to come and stand before You for this circumstance. I want to come and stand before You for this challenge, Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. He experienced the help of God in his life. King Asa experienced. Amen. Do you know? But what happened? It's a sad thing happened in his life. He experienced the help of God, but when another enemy came against him, he did not rely on God. Amen. That was a sad thing in his life. When the million army came against him, he rested upon God. He looked for his help. But there is some other time, the another enemy came against him. But instead of looking upon God, he sent a help note to some other king. Amen. That is the temptation for every one of us. Sometime we will rely upon God. Sometime, you know, we will try to rely upon some people. Amen. That's why Bible says, better put your trust upon God. Amen. This same King Asa, who experienced the help of God in his life, he sent a note to another king to come and help for his challenge. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord did not like it. Hallelujah. I want to show you that verse also. That is the same thing God is expecting from us, which we should not do it. Amen. It's a temptation for us also. Sometimes we rely on God, sometimes we will rely on people. Amen. Hallelujah. We can read that verse. 2 Chronicles chapter 16, verse 1. 2 Chronicles chapter 16, verse 1.
In the 36th year of the reign of Asa, Baasha king of Israel came up against Judah and Judah.
Baasha king of Israel came up against Judah and built Ramah, that he might let none go out or come into Asa king of Judah. And the king of Israel came and blocked it, so that no one should go out, no one should come in. No food cannot go, nothing can come in, nothing can go out, like that. He blocked. He had a challenge. Just one king came and built something and blocking it. This time not the million army. Amen. That's why I want to encourage you, whatever the challenges, rely on God. Do not lean on your own understanding. God can help you in every circumstance. Amen. We can read the verse 2, what this king Asa did. We can read verse 2 and 3.
See, I have sent you silver and gold. Come, break your treaty with Baasha, king of Israel, so that he will withdraw from me.
Amen. What he did? He sent the note to king of Syria. Along with the note, what he sent? Gold and silver. Amen. Hallelujah. He relied on his gold and silver. He relied on the king of Syria. Hallelujah. Instead of relying on God, he failed to rely on God. He relied on the people and the money. He thought, if I send this money, that king can come and help me. Amen. Hallelujah. Many people, they used to say, right, all we need is money. If you have money, you can do everything. Right? What happened to this king? Actually, the money worked in the life of this king. We can read the verse. Next verse.
So Ben-Hadad, king Asa, and sent the captains of his army against the cities of Israel.
So he sent people to help this king. We can read the verse.
Now it happened, when Baasha heard it, he stopped building Ramah and ceased his work.
See, when the king came, when the king of Syria sent the people, what the first king he did, the Baasha who came and blocked the way, he stopped his building work. He stopped. He doesn't want to block the town anymore. We can read the next verse.
Then King Asa took all Judah and they carried away the stones and timber of Ramah, which Baasha had used for building
Okay. So tell me now, this is this a victory for King Asa or not? It's a victory. It's a great victory. Because whatever the purpose he tried to do, he achieved it. The king of Syria came and helped him. So Baasha went away. He took all the woods and he brought it and he built some other things, right? Hallelujah. Sometimes it may look as a victory for our human mind. We can say, hey, I achieved. How you achieved the things? How you got the help? Yes, I got the help from King of Syria. It looks like a blessing, but it's not a blessing. Amen? Hallelujah. What happened? We can read the next verses. Then you can understand how it cannot be a blessing. Mm.
Mm. Because you have relied on the king of Syria and have not relied on the Lord your God, therefore the army of the king of Syria has escaped from your hand.
The Lord sent a messenger to King Asa and said, why you did not rely on God? Amen. Because you relied on king of Syria, the king of Syria will be a trouble for you. Amen. Hallelujah. Sometimes, you know, we will do things for our temporary blessings, temporary relief. But the Lord sent the messenger, because you relied on King of Syria, you will have a trouble through King of Syria. We can read the next verse. Mm. See, the Lord is reminding him about the incidents which he faced earlier, the Ethiopian. Mm.
Hmm. A huge army with very many chariots and horsemen. Yet because you relied on the Lord.
The Lord was telling him, hey, that day you relied on God, God gave away all the Ethiopians in your hand. Even though it was a great army, the Lord delivered everyone in your hands. Why you did not rely upon God this time? Amen. It looks like a blessing, but it was not a real blessing. The Lord is expecting us to rely on Him for every help, for all the time. Amen? The Lord is expecting that. Hallelujah. We can read the next verse.
For the eyes of the Lord went to and fro throughout the whole earth to show Himself strong on behalf of those whose heart is loyal to Him.
In this
you have done foolishly.
But for King of Asa, it looked like a smart thing. It worked out, right? Hallelujah. It worked out. The king of Baasha and the king of Israel, Baasha, went away. But in God's sight, it was a foolish thing. Amen. Hallelujah. We can do things in several ways, but we need to check whether it's wise in the sight of God. Whether it's wise or foolishness. Amen? We need to rely on God for every help. We should not rely upon our own understanding. We should not rely upon money. We should not think with money I can do all things. Maybe it works out for you, but in the sight of God, it will be a foolish thing. Amen? Bible says, we can finish that verse. Because of this thing,
Therefore from now on
you shall have wars. Amen. When we are not relying on God, it will bring more wars. But when you rely on God, it will remove every wars. Amen. How many of you believe that the Lord alone your help? Amen. We need to rely on God for every single help. Amen. Doesn't matter million army or one man. Amen. Several chariots or one building. It's blocking our way. Hallelujah. But when we rely on God, His ways are higher than our ways. He will do great things. He will help us in the miraculous way. Hallelujah. How many of you believe that? Amen. Hallelujah. Bible says, weeping will be in the evening, but the joy will come in the morning. Over the night, God can change the things. Hallelujah. When we rely on God, He knows how to do the things in our life. This evening, Lord wants to encourage us to rely on Him throughout this year to get the help from God. Hallelujah. For everything, ask the Lord, Lord, help me, Lord. You alone can help me. You alone my help. Hallelujah. Then you will see the mighty hand of God during the time of challenges. Amen. When the evil surrounds you, the Lord will come through and the Lord would do the battle and He will destroy all the challenges. Amen. Hallelujah. The second thing, the Lord wants to help us in the time of trouble. Hallelujah. Psalm 108 verse 12. Here this psalmist says, help of man is nothing, Lord. We can read Psalm 108 verse 12.
Give us help from trouble, for the help of man is useless. True God,
give us
help from trouble, for the help of man is useless.
Hallelujah. This man realized help of man is useless. So Lord, you help us. Hallelujah. In sometimes, you know, as I said, God alone can help us. Amen. The help of man, it's nothing. Amen. Useless. But sometimes God can use people to help us. Amen. It happened in the life of Elijah. God used ravens to help him. God used a widow lady to help him. Amen. But they did not rely upon the sources. They relied upon God who sends the sources. Amen. All the glory, honor belongs to the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. We can read 1 Samuel chapter 23, verse 26, 27, 28. In some circumstances, God will help in the tremendous way. We can read 1 Samuel chapter 23, verse 26, 27, 28. I am going to finish in a few minutes. 1 Samuel chapter 23, verse 26, 27, 28. Then Saul went on one... you can read, ma.
Saul went on one side of the mountain, and David and his men on the other side of the mountain.
Saul was keep on chasing David to kill him. One fine moment, what happened? Saul and his men were encircling David and his men to take them. It's kind of final moment for David. He was encircled by Saul and his army. He was supposed to be killed. There is no other way to escape. But what happened if you read the next verse?
But
a messenger came to Saul saying, hurry and come. For the Philistines have invaded the land. Amen. From where this messenger came? Out of bloom, the messenger came. Amen. Hallelujah. David thought, this is the final moment. That's it. I'm done. They are going to catch him. Amen. It's a hopeless situation. Hallelujah. But always David relied on the Lord. Amen. That's why David says in Psalm 16:8, I have set the Lord before me always. Hallelujah. Always. I have set the Lord before me always. When you set the Lord before you always, He knows how to protect you. Amen. Nobody can approach Saul that time, but one messenger, God, I believe that God alone sent the messenger. How many of you believe that? God can do miraculous way. God can do the things in the miraculous way. Amen. Hallelujah. One time, you know, I was working in a place. But it's not happened in this country. When I was in India, it happened. I was working, so that boss, he did not like me. So he wants to send me out from that place. He wants to send away from the place. So he tried to send me out from that place, but he couldn't. Finally, he put a lot of pressure upon me to resign that job on my own. Right? Every day it became a torture for me. Every day he was asking me to give the resignation letter and send away. Like that. Go away from that place on my own. Every day it became a torture. But one fine day, it stopped. He did not ask me to give the resignation letter, nothing. I was wondering what happened. Why he stopped? Then another person came and told me, you know, somebody called and tell that person, don't ask him to give resignation letter. Did you ask someone to call that person? I said, no, I did not know anyone. But the person who was witnessing that, he said, I was there when he received the phone call. How it happened? I believe that the miraculous way the Lord helped me and get me out of that situation. Hallelujah. God can do all things. Hallelujah. The heavenly way, the help will come. The help will come from above. When He helps you, He will help you beyond your thinking and imagination. David experienced such a help. The messenger came and gave a message to Saul. Hey, Philistines are coming to invade our land. Well, next verse. Mm. Amen. Therefore, Saul returned from pursuing David. Hallelujah. And went against the Philistines. So they called that place the Rock of Escape. How he escaped? Through the help of God. Amen. At the right time, God helped David. Because he relied on God all the time. Amen. The Lord can help you the miraculous way. Wherever the man cannot help you, God can help you. If you see the life of Daniel, that king threw him in the lion's den. Bible says before he threw him in the lion's den, throughout the day, the king tried to escape Daniel. Amen? The king tried to stop him from throwing into the lion's den. Even though he was a king, he could not change his ordinance. He could not change his order. But he tried. That's why Bible says, men's help are useless. As a man, the king tried to protect Daniel. Because the king loved Daniel, he tried to keep him away from the lion's den. But Bible says he couldn't. But finally he said, Daniel, the God one who you worship, he will deliver you from the mouth of the lion. Amen? People's helps are very limited. They can help us only certain limit. But God can help beyond the human understanding. Amen? So the king threw him in the lion's den. The early morning the king came again to the lion's den. Asking Daniel, Daniel, is your God is able to deliver you from the mouths of the lion? Amen? Then Daniel told, yes, my king. Amen? The Lord sent the angel from above and that tied the mouths of the lion, which no man can do it, but God did it. Hallelujah. We need to understand, my God can help beyond any limitation. The help will come from above. From where the angel came? Bible says, the God of heaven sent the angel for Daniel. Throughout this year, you will see the help of God in the miraculous way. Amen. How many of you believe that? How many of you need this type of help? Amen. Maybe you are going through financial challenges. God can help you beyond your understanding. The miraculous way it will happen. Amen. Do not put your trust upon your savings. Do not put your trust upon your money. Do not put your trust upon your job. God can help you anyway. Hallelujah. Sometimes, you know, people will go through discouragement if they are not getting proper hike. Right? But God can help you better than your hike. No, amen? Amen? Amen. How many of you believe that? Amen. Amen. How it will happen? Somehow it will happen. Amen? David never thought one messenger will come and give the message to Saul. But it happened. Daniel never thought the angel will come and tie the mouths of the lion. But it happened. Amen. His ways are always higher than our ways. His thoughts are always higher than our thoughts. Amen. Hallelujah. If you believe, you shall see the glory of God. We will see the mighty hand of God. We will see the mighty help of God this year. Amen. Finally, the Lord wants to help you in guidance. Psalm 32 verse 8. We'll finish with that verse. Psalm 32 verse 8. I will instruct you and teach you. He will help us to know the ways which we should go. Amen. Hallelujah. How many of you need a help in this area? Amen. If he teaches, that way will be a best way. We need the help in this area. Amen. Because many times we do not know which way we need to go. Hallelujah. Amen. When we do not know and when we choose the way on our own, it will cause more troubles. But when you get the help from God to know the ways of God, it will help you to reach the destiny. Amen. Bible says when the children of God came out of Egypt, they were walking through the wilderness. They did not know how to go. They did not know where to go. But Bible says, when they came out of the Egypt, the Lord put the pillar of cloud and pillar of fire to lead them. Amen. Bible says, the Lord was there. Always, day and night, the Lord was there to guide them. Amen. Bible says, he went before them to show them their ways. Hallelujah. How many of you went for some tour? Who will go before you? The guide. Amen. When you go for some tour, the guide will go before you, right? The guide will go before you and the guide will teach you about the ways, about the circumstances and everything. Amen. When you go for the like a wildlife sanctuary or some jungle, some forest, if the guide goes before you, that guide will take you in the right path. He knows all the path of that forest. You will not be lost. Amen. You will reach the other side. Hallelujah. The guide has to go before you and help you to walk through the jungle, right? In our life journey also, we need the help of our guide. The Lord said, I will be your guide. I want to help you to walk in the right way. Amen. When you ask the Lord, he will help you in this area. Amen. He will teach you, go this way. He will teach you, don't go this way. Amen. Hallelujah. Again, I want to say, our wisdom is very, very, our brain is very, 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 very small. Amen. But his ways and his thoughts are much, much, much greater than us. When you get His help, He will lead you in the right way. Amen. Shall we all stand?